Cassiopeia?
Cassiopeia wouldn't be that good because there's so much long range on the side of the sandboxes. So, looks like Talia. This has been something that is popping up a little bit.
Talia's going to be able to offer that as the Jax is being considered here.
Jungle
that could
Jax.
Be the, yeah, that's the jungle pick here for On Fleek. Having to go well into the jungle pool and not wanting to pick up the Olaf as well. On Fleek's actually looking for Khan here. Umbral Dash should be available here to get him out of some potential trouble, but he's just going to face check a Counter-Strike. That is bad news. Khan turning it around, though. They're looking for more teleport. Going to come in from Dove.
The question.
Even if he throws the EQ.
There's the Cataclysm as Marta gets the Battle Dance, but just dives in on top. He's going to be able to get out with the Grand Entrance, but Clid has to flash. Marta below 200 health. True Shot Barrage avoided. That was a very weird Cataclysm. I'm slightly perplexed as well. But Sandbox will transition this one into a very easy
come in. Ezreal has the Iceborne Gauntlet, but with an Open Dragon being the next one coming up in 55 seconds.
Marta, quickness already in. He is going to utilize the flash to get the Grand Entrance, but now they're just going to gank some plates. On Fleek walks over a control ward down, but that is a flash used from Marta that Sandbox might be able to utilize. Summit really struggling here against Khan, but evens out the trade.
Yeah.
Still staying in the area.
Oh, man.
Infernal Chains are going to land. Don't get the pullback as Clid wants to get the knock-up. Isn't going to be able to do so as On Fleek gets one stun. Faker turns up. Flash has to be used to get over the Weaver's Wall. Seismic Shove is a little bit off-kilter as Dove has already used the teleport, so still
has his shield removed,
but is otherwise unperturbed by the ultimate here as Clid gets the Flash Cataclysm. Dove, his passive is there.
Nice
sidestep on the Seismic Shove. Gets underneath the turret, and now Summit wants some more. In goes Khan, but immediately Lightbound in the mid lane. And once again, no first blood on either side.
That's really
what he does for these sort of compositions with the fact that he can sit in the mid lane and just be really comfortable. Weaver's Wall coming in. Clid's looking for another one. Good knock up there onto Joker. Takes the second Q from Khan, but Khan gets turned on. Has to go golden. No reset just yet. Lightbind. Sorry, Final Spark comes in, but it's not enough. First kill goes over to Teddy as Khan is looking to go home, might have a teleport available to come back, but that's one for one in the end. Both junglers are dead. Very, very slow, but once again, it's Clid trying to start things off and ultimately in the end getting punished. Khan tried his darndest to get things going.
Yeah, and this is basically, Faker uses the Weaver's Wall, but his teammates aren't totally in position to follow up, and it was actually a really close call for Khan. There's probably a bunch of scenarios where you replay this, he ends up actually going down. Everyone times their stuff correctly, even against this flash, so... Now they're talking about actually preparing Baron.
Yeah.
They're talking about who has no flash and...
Waiting around here. Trinity Force completed. Two items are pretty powerful as Joker. The Lux has been impressing me.
Yeah.
This is a guy that played basically three champions in the spring season, and none of them were Lux.
Oh, man.
Okay, Blue Trinket is well-timed as Sandbox are looking to turn, most likely. They just want to bring SKT to them. Clid, is he going to start another weird fight?
This has been the downfall of many teams.
Okay, Weaver's Wall to bring Faker in, but the Baron does fall down. Flash immediately from Summit, but he's over the Weaver's Wall. Cataclysm actually is what gets them out of there as the Jarvan is going to fall immediately. Oh! Teddy with the Blade Caller! Gigantic play into the backline as Khan now has the reset on the World Ender and SKT dive on top of Sandbox. Better late than never when it comes to the engage.
And so they managed to bring down some of the members on the side of Sandbox.
On top of his head as he's been farming way more than Ghost has. On Fleek gonna get knocked up as there's the Seismic Shove we've been waiting for. Faker throws out another one, but On Fleek gets out with his flash. Now, fights on other fronts. Faker looking for even more as the Weaver's Wall was jumped off of, and Sandbox just seemed to have more members on the map right now. Ghost is making sure Teddy can't even get over towards his own inner turret.
Totally on the defensive.
And it accelerates the Elder Drake.
Elder's coming now. Why did you take it?
They maybe were trying to force another Drake, but they were too slow. In the meantime, this tower is just going to fall down. You can see the siege potential of these three members of Sandbox. Okay, in goes Clid. It's another Cataclysm, but I think it's cataclysmic for SKT. He's going to go down for nothing. And now SKT, I don't think they can actually defend this inhibitor. Sandbox have played so slow and steady, so against their normal playstyle, but SKT have had absolutely no answer to it.
Yeah,
now SKT will have an impossible choice to make.
Yeah.
As Armada, he's going to dive on forward. No one gets knocked up. It's a decent charm. Weaver's Wall is going to push them into the back line. That's going to be GA dead. Popped immediately, but Sandbox just have way too much to go on. Ghost is alive in the back line. Somehow is Teddy against the world. It's been the case so many different times. Realm Warp, though, is going to close the distance. Everyone trying to kill Teddy. He survives for so long, and now Sandbox will have to go back to try and find themselves a Baron. There's on Fleek. He had the Counter-Strike, and that is going to be that. Almost the ace, but I believe Clid respawned in time.
He does end up respawning, but that's going to be all that she wrote here in game number one. So SK Telecom, they lost on blue side, Atlas.
They did.
I think that's it.
It's unfortunate.
Just go to a winner's interview. Right?
Yeah. This was the side that they were able to win on in the past, but Sandbox, they're able to mix it up. It sort of just depends on how things go. Sandbox Gaming are going to pick up the win over SKT in a very slow game. Joker doesn't come off as a Lux player. He was basically a three-trick in spring season. Now, sort of added Nautilus to that repertoire, but feels very similar to sort of his Tahm Kench, Shen playstyle that he had before. Lux